Assalamu alaikum. So today the topic of our lecture will be the requirements that are necessary for the multi-dwelling or multi-story plumbing systems. So first of all, we should know what is a multiple dwelling and what is a multi-story dwelling. So multiple dwelling actually refer to such a structure that house more than one individual or family in separate units. These types of dwellings can be either apartment buildings or hotels, military barrack buildings, boarding schools, nursing homes, and any such location where a number of people are living closely together. An example of multiple dwelling, if say you have two portions in your house and in one portion you are living as one family and the other portion you have rented it. So there are actually two families living in that house. Whereas multi-story dwellings are those structures which have more than one floor, but in the context of plumbing, a multi-story building is one that can be fully and adequately served by the municipal water supply because the pressure for that building is too limited. Multi-story buildings, they require a proper drainage, sewage and venting systems so that these systems can accommodate as many people living in generally vertical arrangement. So where we have a public water supply systems, but they are so overburdened because they have to supply to such a large area, they cannot provide adequate pressure on a continuous basis. So the water must be stored on the site during periods where that multi-story building cannot have adequate pressure to fill a gravity storage tank. And the size of that storage tank will vary accordingly. It depends upon what is the daily water demand of the building. Now what we do is that we divide multi-story buildings into different zones according to the water pressure and its control. The lower 2 to 3 stories, we can generally supply water directly from the public water main because the pressure is strong enough to supply up till maximum of 3 stories. But upper stories, we usually group them in 5 to 8 stories, and each group is then provided by a pressure boosted storage tank that we have installed a specific pressure pump that boosts the pressure and take the water from 3rd story to next 8 stories and store that in a storage tank. Then the water storage tank from the 8th story will be connected to another pressure booster pump that will carry that water to another 8 stories, and that's how the system works. So there are 3 systems by which we can boost the water pressure. So most of the times in multi-story buildings, the pressure has to be increased to reach the upper levels of the structure. So how do we accomplish it? First of all, we install booster pumps. These are a series of staged pumps or variable speed pumps that we install to provide increased pressure for water drawn from the municipal water supply. And these pumps supplement pressures from the existing water supply sources. Then we have a gravity-based roof tank. So water is pumped from a ground level or maybe basement level storage tank straight into the roof tank. And then that water acquires a sufficient pressure because of the gravity and it reaches the lower stories. But of course, to pump the water from ground level to the roof level, we still need a booster pump. And then we use hydropneumatic storage tanks. So the water from the municipal supply lines or maybe gravity storage tanks is pumped into the hydropneumatic storage tank that uses internal air pressure to increase the water supply line pressure. And then through that pneumatic storage tank, the water is, with the adequate pressure, it is pumped to various stories in a multi-story building. Avoidance of cross-contamination. Okay, so in a multi-occupancy dwelling and multi-story buildings, it is very important that the plumbing system that we design in those buildings should not cross-contaminate the drinking water from one dwelling to another. Every dwelling, every apartment should have their own clean drinking water supply. Even the drinking water supply for two apartments should not mix. And we make sure that we prevent this possibility as much as possible by carefully designing our plumbing system. Carelessness or unsanitary behavior from one resident or tenant should not affect the water quality of any other tenant. This is the main reason that why we as designers try to carefully design the plumbing system. Now, this avoidance of cross-contamination is also important when we have buildings like, say, Centaurus Mall, which is a shopping center, a residential hub, and it also have some offices. So there is a different type of occupancy taking place in that building. So we make sure that the plumbing design is carefully laid for all these three occupancies. Then we provide control valves must in a multi-dwelling or multi-story buildings. Next is control valves. Valves are actually plumbing fixtures that control the water flow from one pipe to another. This valve can either stop the water altogether, stop the water flow, or we can actually regularize it to a smaller flow to a larger flow. So to avoid the contamination of the plumbing system for drinking water, we have to provide control valves to each individual unit in a multi-dwelling or a multi-story building. And this is also going to ensure that water supplies to separate units can be shut off during maintenance or repairs, and it is not going to affect the water supply to the other dwellings. So control valves also give this opportunity to the building managers or owners to stop the water supply to the units, to those dwellings, to those apartments which are unoccupied, so that we can avoid the water leakage in those apartments. So maybe if that building is in such an area where it's too cold and there is a tendency that water may get frozen into the water pipelines, so control valves help a lot in such situation, because you off the control valve and there is no water in the pipelines which are actually laid within the apartment which is unoccupied. Then drainage system considerations when we talk about the multi-story or multi-dwelling buildings. The drains from the plumbing fixtures are connected to a vertical drain stack. We actually call it a duct as well. It's a vertical shaft that conveys the waste and sewage to below the lowest floor of the building. It is necessary that we provide proper fixture drain traps, and all those traps should be properly vented so that there is no siphonage action in the lower stories and the water trap seal does not break. The vent pipe that are coming out of this fixture drain traps, that must extend through the roof to the outdoors. These vent pipes can run individually, or we can combine one or more vents as we go through the roof. Now, if the building is over 10 stories high, the drainage stack requires a relief vent, and that relief vent will be connected at a specific interval from the top and connected to a vent stack that terminates above the roof. This relieves and equalizes the pressure in the drainage stack to maintain the water seal and traps serving plumbing fixtures. We try our best that if it's possible, the sanitary drainage from a multi-dwelling building or a multi-story building should, you know, discharge to the public sewer by gravity method. And if that multi-story building has a basement in which there are plumbing fixtures below the ground level, we should to install a pump there that carries or boosts the waste material from the fixtures to the public sewer through a pump. Mostly we use vacuum drainage systems in multi-story buildings. What a vacuum does is that it creates a differential pressure between the atmosphere and the vacuum, and that becomes actually the driving force that actually pushes the wastewater towards the vacuum station. So here are these few possibilities. If we encounter any of these possibilities while designing our plumbing system for a multi-story building, then we have to consider using a vacuum drainage system. So first condition is if there is a water shortage. Second condition is there is a limited sewerage capacity. Limited sewerage capacity means that especially if we have stories under the ground floor, like basements, and there are several fixtures, and then there are several plumbing fixtures over there, we always provide a septic tank. Septic tank is the storage space for collecting all the waste from these bathrooms, and then from that septic tank a vacuum drainage system is attached, and through the differential pressure that waste is sucked into a drain which is on the ground level. So if the capacity of that septic tank is less as compared to the occupancy of those basement, then we provide vacuum drainage system. Like, it is must for that. Where drainage by gravity becomes impractical, this is more or less the same like a limited sewerage capacity, because the main municipal sewer, main municipal drain is actually located above the building occupancy. We also use vacuum drainage systems in hospitals, hotels, office buildings, or areas where we have a congested usage of the toilets, where we have restricted construction conditions. There are certain areas where we cannot go beyond a certain depth. Therefore, we have to provide a vacuum drainage system. And if there is a building refurbishment going on, that means that building does have a normal drainage system, but that is not in use because of the building renovation, etc. Therefore, we use a temporary vacuum drainage system. Dual water supply system. So there is a possibility that there are two different grades of water that a building is receiving. Like the building is also receiving fresh water from the municipal a water supply system, and they also have a water storage tank. And for this situation, we always provide two separate piping systems. So example is that to provide a tap at a sink which supplies water directly from the incoming water surface, whereas all other plumbing fixtures within that apartment, they are fed from the storage tank. So obviously storage tank water is not as fresh as that of a fresh supply that is coming from the municipal water tank. Sometimes we do have to install a water softener to treat part of our domestic system. So if that has to be done, we should have to have two piping systems. Because of different issues, we cannot soften a huge amount of water. So if we have separate lines for the different grades, that we can actually soften one grade of water which is actually supplying us drinking water. So we are welcoming this approach of applying two pipe systems because we wish to conserve water, and we recycle our grey water and we use it for the irrigation purposes or for gardening outside. But the main and important concern about this dual water supply system is that there should not to be any cross contamination. There should not to be any cross connections while we are installing that supply system, or we are repairing it, and by mistake we do the cross connections. So we have to be very careful while laying this dual water supply system. Firefighting system is very important when it comes to a multiple dwelling or a multi-story building. So they have to have fire protection systems, and most of these have either the fire extinguishers or they have a sprinkler variety systems. When we are going to study firefighting system in detail, you will get to know what are the different types of fire extinguishers or the systems that we can use to extinguish a fire. If that multi-story building is an industrial or commercial establishment, then it is possible that we have more system of pipings, like more than one or more than two. That is to carry cooling or process water from a secondary source or main water that has been specially treated for the purpose. Water storage vessels. So whenever we are designing a plumbing system for multi-story or multi-dwelling building, we have to make sure that we provide separate water storage vessels for all of these categories, so that we do not run out of water supply from the main water storage tanks when we have an emergency. So we should have a separate water storage for sanitary flushing, separate water storage for supply of drinking water, firefighting system, air conditioning, and we must have a contingency reserve. This contingency reserve can either be used for aiding the firefighting water storage or air conditioning water storage, or maybe if we have run short of drinking water or the water that we can use for sanitary flushing. So when we design a water storage tank, there are certain requirements that we have to keep in mind. For every water storage tank, there should be adequate headroom and side access available in that, so that we can easily inspect that water tank. We can clean it and maintain it, whether we talk about the interior of the tank or the exterior of the tank. Headroom is basically it's an extra space given between a normal person's height and the top slab of the water tank. So you can say that the depth of the water tank should not be less than, say, 6 feet or 6.5 feet, so that when a person is standing within a water tank for its cleaning purpose or for any kind of maintenance and repair, he can easily stand over there and his head doesn't touch the top slab of the water tank. And wherever the depth of the storage tank exceeds 2 meters, we always have to provide a ladder. And these ladders are basically designed on the standard measurements, so that the person can reach the bottom of the water tank using those ladder. And these ladders should also be complied with the entry safety codes. Then comes that what type of materials should we use for water storage tanks. So we have to make sure that the internal surface of the tank should be coated with a protective coating which is drinking water approved. If that water storage supply is meant for supplying drinking water, we must make sure that the storage water tanks should be made of non-corrosive material. There should not to be any rusting, whether inside of the tank or outside of the tank. If it's inside of the tank, obviously the rust will start leaving off the surface and start mixing with the water, and we can actually see that rust traces coming out of our taps. And if it's on the exterior side, even then it's harmful, because if this corrosion exceeds beyond the limit, it is going to make the material porous and there would be a water leakage. Porosity also means that impurities from outside would be able to contaminate the water which is present inside the water storage tank. Third point is that whatever fittings that we are using, whether it's a tank, pipes, we are using heating coils or anything related to this water storage tank, all of these items should be of similar metal. This is to prevent electrolysis. Electrolysis means that there will be a certain type of charge which will generate in the water because of the reaction with the different types of metals, and it will separate different ions and chemicals present within the water. So we do not want that thing. So we make sure that all of these things are of similar metal. And if we are using steel for the tank and for the piping, it should be heavily galvanized. The last thing that we must consider is the fixture unit calculations for multiple dwellings. This fixture unit calculation is a concept in which we calculate that how many number of drinking water supply and drainage water piping we will require within a large building. Ideally, all the pipes that we install, they should be of such a size that whatever the number of fixtures, whether they are present in the kitchen or the bathroom, which are connected to those pipes, should be served even if all of those fixtures are operated at the same time in the building. Although this is a very rare case, because not every apartment will be using their kitchen sink at the same time, not every washroom in that building is going to flush the WC at any given time. But in our practical life, the chances of using all the fixtures simultaneously at any given time is very less. So the piping design criteria that we use in that building can be relaxed to some degree. So this was all about the basic information that you must know while designing the plumbing system for multi-dwelling or multi-story buildings.